Hey guys, and welcome back to another Unfiltered Gamer board game review for the game Micro Medusa by Floyd Liu and art by John DeCampos. In this two-player or solo mode game, one player will be playing as Medusa, the multi-headed gorgon, which uses its unique tentacles and eyes to turn travelers into stone. And of course, the other player being the hero of the story, going into the cave to slay Medusa and avoiding turning themselves into stone. Each player is going to get an assortment of tiles. Medusa is going to be laying tiles down on the board from its famous head, trying to use its eyes to turn the traveler into stone, or connect enough pieces to have their snake's body grow long, whereas the traveler is trying to chop off Medusa's heads, or attempt to make sure that Medusa is not able to turn him into stone. And only one player is going to win. With multiple victory conditions and choices in this game, it's going to be an intense 6 to 12 minutes of micro Medusa-ing. Okay, let's take a look at how to set the game up, and of course how to play, and then what I think about it. The setup for micro Medusa is rather simple and quick. What you're going to do is you're going to give one player the Medusa tiles, and the other player the hero tiles. The hero tiles are going to have hearts, shields, torches, and swords. And you're going to give the hero player two hearts to start with and one of each of the different weaponry. Then you'll set aside an extra area in which the hero will be able to select tiles, one being a torch, an extra sword, an extra shield, and an extra heart that they'll be able to utilize in each of the rounds of play. For the Medusa character, simply take the head of Medusa, place it in the middle of the board, shuffle the tiles, and then create a stack of tiles for that player. Then, draw out one secret tile face down for the Medusa player, and flip over four Medusa tiles onto the game playing board that they will be using for the draft. Once that's done, Micro Medusa is ready to be played. Let's cut into how to play the game and all the different strategies and ways to win. Playing the game Micro Medusa is just as simple as it is to set up. The first thing that's going to happen is a drafting phase. The Medusa player is going to start with one of their face-down tiles already gathered, and then they're going to select one of the four face-down tiles available in their drafting pool. Take that, gather it, and collect it face down in front of them. Then replenish the pool by placing another tile out in order to form four more tiles. Then once again, selecting another tile, and of course replenishing it. Once the Medusa player has three tiles face down that the other player only saw two of, remember that first one was secret, then the drafting will go ahead and transfer to the hero. In which case, the hero already has two hearts and one of each weapon, and they can choose to gather any of the extra weapons they want, but only one. Do they want an extra shield, torch, sword, or heart? And they'll go ahead and select one of those and place it in their active area. The rest of them won't be used until next round, provided the game is still going on. Then it goes on to the playing phase. The Medusa player will choose any of their tiles face down, and they could be in their hand as well, shuffled, and places it down next to Medusa. Once that happens, then the hero will get a chance to play one of their weapons and connect it to the tile that was just played on Medusa. If the player thinks an eyeball was played, maybe they'll want to shield it. If the player thinks that a connector piece of Medusa was played, like extra long tentacle, then they might want to try and burn it. And if a snakehead is played, they want to chop it off. In this case, the hero will go ahead and select a shield, and thusly, that concludes the placement. Then you'll go ahead and reveal Medusa and see what happens. In this case, an eyeball was played, and the shield was used. Eyeballs typically will turn the hero into stone, thusly turning their hearts into stone hearts, and if the hero has no hearts available, meaning all of them turn to stone, the hero will lose the game. And in this case, they are lucky enough to defend against that, thusly flipping over the tile that was played on Medusa and protecting themselves. Another thing to note is when you play tiles down, you have to make sure that they are connected correctly. Whenever an eyeball is popping out, it has to be connected to a Medusa attachment, or it has to be attached to the Medusa head. Each of the different pieces on Medusa is going to have a little bit of a length structure. Think of any other puzzle game, and that's how you have to work with connecting pieces. And of course, they're going to be limited, the hero, with what they have left over. The shield will stay here for the rest of the round. Then Medusa is going to select one more tile and put it face down, and thusly the player will now have a chance to go ahead and once again play one of their tiles face up and attempt to deal with Medusa's threat. Medusa will reveal, and then you will go ahead and check to see what happens. In this case, the eye was not shielded, Thusly, the eye will trigger and turn one of the hero's hearts into stone. And then, after that, that will stay revealed. These will come back, and you're going to refresh and begin the round once again, with the Medusa player having their one hidden tile and going ahead and selecting the different tiles in order to create a draft again. Gathering a new piece, refreshing, gathering another piece. The player will then get a chance to gather a piece from their reserve pool and add it to their active area, and rinse and repeat. And basically, that is how you play the game. You'll go back and forth until one of the different victory conditions is met. For Medusa to win, Medusa is going to either need to create a long enough pathway in order for there to be at least three tiles or more, and then connect a snakehead to that. The other way Medusa can win is by turning all of the hero's available hearts into stone. And finally, the way Medusa is able to win is if they are able to gather, or she is able to gather, three snakeheads. That is the only three ways Medusa can win. The hero can win, however, if they are able to stop Medusa from being able to grow, thusly preventing the player from placement, because if there's no connecting area, then Medusa will lose. Or if Medusa runs out of tiles, meaning Medusa still can't be by the time all of her tiles are out, the hero will win as well. And finally, if Medusa will lose three snakeheads, the hero slashes three of the different snakeheads out on the field, then the hero will win that way as well. And that's basically how you play the game, going back and forth from drafting to placement to redrafting until one of those six conditions is met. And when that happens, that hero will win the game, or of course, villain. There's also a solo mode to the game, which plays very similarly to the two-player mode, but just one of them is going to kind of be a randomized dropping, and you're kind of playing back and forth, debating on what was drafted, what you think is more likely to come out, and so on and so forth. And it works for both players in that way. But that's the game Micro Medusa. Fairly simple, fairly straightforward two-player game with a solo mode attachment as well. So Micro Medusa is a little bit of like a rock, paper, scissors, and a little bit of like a strategy tile laying game, because you're trying to deal with the tiles that you know that Medusa has in their hand. Now, there's always going to be one random one, or at least there might be one random one, in their hand, thusly making it a little more challenging for the player to remember what Medusa has. And it's very important for the player to remember what they have, because if the player, if the Medusa player has three eyeballs, they're in trouble if the hero knows that, because the hero will just gather two shields during the draft phase and thusly be able to shield each time, guaranteeing Medusa will no longer get to have those eyeballs, blocking off space for Medusa, and eventually making Medusa lose the game. Whereas the Medusa player has to kind of keep a variety of different tiles in their secret hidden draft area here. Now, the sad thing is for Medusa is the player does get to see what is being drawn and face down and what is being played, and if they have a good memory, they're going to be able to predict not precisely what would be played, but what most likely can be played. And then it comes down to kind of maybe a 50-50 shot as to what's the most advantageous for Medusa to do. Sometimes Medusa might be limited to only a very few selective moves, or only one in order to keep in the game, because as the player gets either lucky or strategically chooses the right pieces, Medusa is going to be limited on where they can place. Having big pieces that allow them the Medusa to connect to multiple areas is going to be really useful, and if they don't get that out by either bluffing the first time and playing it the next time, or just playing it the first time and hoping for the best, then Medusa will only have four spaces in which to connect to, and that's going to be very detrimental for the Medusa player. And the hero has to also have that memory. They have to be able to remember when Medusa played stuff, what they played and what they gathered, and what's most advantageous. Whether they want to gather a specific type of active item from the reserve pool will be important as well. And when they run out of hearts, they'll lose. So sometimes drafting a heart will be important. One thing to note too is that when the player runs out of hearts, they lose. But when they draft another heart, they'll get to keep it for the remainder of the game, meaning that if they only had two hearts and they needed a third one because one just turned into stone, they won't get an extra weapon that round, but they can keep themselves from losing the game and prevent themselves from having to from basically restart. This game has a lot of back and forth, and it's very, like, what are they going to do? And which that gives you a lot of stress. And you're like, I don't know if I want to do this or that. And for me, I really enjoy these type of games. Me and Callie were going back and forth debating on what each other were playing, when we were going to play it. And it also kind of creates this little Medusa character that kind of spreads out around the map. This like snake-like critter that's dropping down eyeballs and snakes and all that good stuff. And thematically, it works very well as well. This is a micro game. It's not extremely intense. There's not a whole bunch of variants. There's the two-player game, the single-player game, and you can play on either side as a single player. And your objective is just to simply counter whatever the other player is playing. That's what you need to do in the game, utilizing the availability of what they have drafted, when they drafted it, and what they are most likely to play. If you like strategically in-depth and stressful type games, because it's got like that back and forth like excitement going on, you're going to really enjoy this game. If you're a little less interested in games that involve like what's going to pop up and when is it going to pop up and having to keep track of certain things, or of course the rock, paper, scissors aspect that is involved in the game, then it might not be for you. But this is a quick game. It's easy to teach, easy to play. It fits pretty much anywhere. It's going to have this little tiny little box, which works really well. And I enjoyed this game. I like the artwork for the game. I like the tile placement. I enjoyed the back and forth of the social aspect that comes into a two-player game like this. Works very well. And this is what I'm going to keep in my collection. This is something that I'll easily see play whenever I've got one of my friends over and we're in between games, or if it's just us two and want to take a break from doing whatever we're doing to jump down and play a tile placement game. This is a solid game that involves Medusa. I haven't seen any games that have this type of theme, which is another bonus point for me. And overall, just a very fun and interactive micro or mini game. I keep wanting to say mini Medusa, but it's micro Medusa. I don't know why I keep wanting to say that, but nevertheless, if you're interested in taking a look at the game, there's a link down below in the description where you can go ahead and pick this game up. I do recommend this game for those people who like two players and single player games. If you don't like games that can be random, games that can be stressful, or games that involve Medusa or like dark type of themes, then it might not be for you. But otherwise, a solid choice of games. Really, really like Floyd Lou's games, and this one is no exception to that rule. Thank you guys for watching another Unfiltered Gamer board game review. If you like this video, check out the rest of our videos here on YouTube. Like, subscribe, hit that bell notification button, and of course, comment down below whether you picked this game up or not. You can also go ahead and check out our website, unfilteredgamer.com. Blog posts, giveaways, currently giving away Drop Drive if you're interested in that game, as well as, of course, the Kickstarter is going on right now. And of course, if you would like, you can go ahead and join us on our live stream every Sunday, 6:30 p.m. PST. We play games just like this one every Sunday. We played Bullet by Level 99 with us. It was a sponsored stream and it included Ferdinand the Cardboard Stacker, so that was a lot of fun. And next week we'll have another one as well, showing you new games that you might want to be interested in purchasing. And you can also see what type of fun we have in the game. And maybe that'll help you determine if you would actually have fun playing that game as well. All right, guys, thank you so much. And as always, I look forward to slicing off Medusa's head with you next time.